drill project for Bora High School. I'm Annalise, this is Madison, and that's Joshua. So we don't really have like a slide for the problem because we don't really have a lot of pictures, but I'll just explain it to you. So for the drill project, there's a class in Bora High School, and it's for a lot of disabled students and also just disabled adults. And Russ Byron runs the class. And basically our problem here is that the students don't really know how to drill up and down because a lot of these disabilities are mental disabilities or just mental, well yeah, mostly mental disabilities. So it's really hard for them to like put pressure on the drill and also keep it straight at the same time. So it's hard for them to drill, it's hard for them to countersink, and it's hard for them to screw in the screw. So our whole objective here is to make a device that will help them with that.
So this was our first draft design that we did. What we have here is actually a base that, well, this was our first setup. So the base was gonna be a clear plexiglass, and then the actual pillars were gonna be PVC pipes, and we were gonna use flanges to connect the two. And then for the drill portion, we were actually looking at doing a type of compression clamp against the top of the drill, having two metal arms coming out from it, and then the metal arms would slide down the slits that we cut in the PVC pipes, and the idea there was two points of contact. Now, a couple of the problems with this one was that, or the things that we decided to change was the plexiglass. Yeah, the idea was to have it clear, but there's already gonna be a big hole cut in the center, so you can already see what you're actually doing. So, plus also, if you drop plexiglass, it is difficult to repair and expensive to buy new pieces, so we wanted to try and find something that would be a little more cost effective if that were to happen. Also, the middle bracket in the center, the idea behind that was to control the countersinking drilling, and so that way they don't go too low. Now, we got a lot of good ideas out of this, but we had a few things we wanted to change, so ultimately we took this and we moved into our first prototype.
Okay, so from this, we kind of decided to base our project off of the rail design instead of doing like a drill press where they would pull a handle. We decided that we wanted it to be like a rail that they could slide down. So we first made the change that instead of using two rails that we would have bars connected to the drill that they would go down, we were going to use one because we thought that that would avoid any torque. We also decided to use Unistrut as the rail instead of PVC because there's already good products that have used rails like to slide along just horizontally instead of vertically, so we knew that this would work. And we also changed, we were gonna start using wood and metal to prototype with instead of PVC because we knew that this would be sturdier and like pressure applied, it wouldn't break. And PVC, we thought we might have a harder time with that.
So this is our first prototype. We didn't build it to be like insanely functional. We built it kind of to just get the concept across to Russ and to get his thoughts on it. He really liked it. He likes this idea, and he gave us some suggestions. So we basically have particle width for the base, and we didn't really like drill a hole into it, but in the next iteration you'll see all the changes we made. And to kind of get the whole like to see like how we would maybe get the drill to roll up and down this railing, we used the little roller, you know, like in your drawers you have like those the rollers pretty much. We used that just to kind of get the concept across. So as you can see, this is like a really, really rough prototype. This was mostly just to get like a concept, an idea to Russ and kind of show him like what we were thinking and to get his thoughts on it. And we also mounted the rail to that piece of wood pretty much. And we put a handle on the back so that they could easily like just pick it up and move it around.
So as Annalise was saying, we wanted to attempt to get their impression on our first prototype. So we actually went to go see Russell at the school. And unfortunately, there weren't any students there at that time that could actually get their hands on our rough first prototype. But Russell actually assists all the students, so he was able to kind of put hands on it and kind of give us some good feedback. He really liked it. His first concept was he liked that we had simplified the idea. He said the simpler, the better. But he also liked the handle that we had put on there to make it more portable. He was a little concerned that if they were holding the handle while physically drilling and the base was narrow, that it might not be that stable. And of course, we want to make sure it's safe because a lot of people are going to be using this. And so that was the one concern there. And then The other thing we talked about was countersinking. The problem with the countersinking was that we initially thought it was going to be a depth thing, which is why we looked at doing a bracket. We were also talking about doing a smaller bracket just to stop the railing from going down. But after actually physically doing it ourselves, we realized it's much more of a time issue. The amount of time you spend drilling, because it only takes about a second to do it, and we're talking millimeters of depth. So there's not a lot of brace that you can put in there to stop that. So we don't currently have a solution for that high want, but we are in the process of trying to come up with one.
Okay, so for our prototype two, after we met with Russ, and he physically took our prototype and he like tested it out on the tables, he found that when they'd be drilling, it's kind of backwards for me, but they might lean back on the handle and use it almost like to put the pressure on. So when drilling, it might tip. So we decided to extend the rear of the base so that it would be sturdier for them. And so when applying that pressure, it wouldn't tip. It would have this back to keep it up. And also, when like drilling, they could put their hand on this piece and drill down and keep like, it'd be almost like a pressure thing so that they could keep the structure like down and sturdy and instead of putting their hand on this handle. The second thing we did was, of course, we like changed. We aren't gonna use the drawer sliders. We're gonna use Unistrut instead because Unistrut's much sturdier and the drawer was just kind of for a visual.
So Unistrut rail to keep the drill vertical. It's really sturdy, it's metal. And we were really concerned about how heavy this is gonna be, but actually the only heavy part of this is a Unistrut, and it's actually not that hard to like lift up, and that was like a huge concern, but yeah, this is really easy to like move around and stuff, and with the handle, like if they have trouble moving it and like grabbing onto it, they can just use the handle to support themselves when they're grabbing it. And yeah, the Unistrut allows for like really smooth movement. The only issue that we have is like we were trying to decide whether we're gonna use metal plates or like trolley wheels for the final product, but a lot of the trolley wheels are kind of expensive, so the sliders might end up being our like final solution. So yeah, that's pretty much it. Oh yeah, also with the oh yeah, and then like one of our biggest problems really at this time is just figuring out how we're gonna attach the drill to the section of the railing that slides up and down.
And talking about that, that has actually been the hardest part about this, is figuring out how to properly connect to a drill, because the drill is not flat. Luckily, the drill that we have to practice on is the exact same drill that they will be using, so we have a direct comparison. We've had a lot of different ideas when it comes to how to actually connect the drill to the slider portion. What we believe we've come up with to be the best, or the least intrusive, is actually the system of adding a second chuck. The chuck's the front part of the drill. You have a metal bar that comes up and it will actually connect to the first chuck. Now what we want to do is put a piece of wood in the center and then put a couple of bearings to allow it to spin unrestricted. And that top one is a kind of a visual one we're looking at. Unfortunately, that piece, while the second chuck isn't hard to find, the bar for it and the complete setup is not available locally, so it's a thing we're going to have to order online. So we don't have it yet, so we haven't been able to test it itself. But what the idea is, as Annalise was saying, you take that portion and you connect it to the slider, and then this whole thing can just go up and down vertically. And it just spins ahead, and there's nothing actually covering up anything on the drill, so the whole drill is still accessible. And the actual client will be able to adjust it at different angles, but it stays vertical, so it's just moving along a horizontal plane. Another thing is, with our project, we don't have a single person that we're going to be using this. It's going to be multiple students with varying levels of disabilities. So ideally we have to make sure this is designed in a way that anybody will be able to use it. So once we get the pieces in, we want to set up another appointment with Russ, actually go and physically, hopefully this time have a bunch of the students use it and give us productive feedback for our final version of this. And on a side note, if we can get these pieces when I order them, I'm looking at getting three of them because we have to have three different drill bits for the pilot hole, the countersink, and the screwing itself. So the idea is to have three of these pieces already set to go. That way, once they drill all their first set of holes, you just loosen it, take out the first one, put in the second one, tighten it, and then they can go through and do their whole next set. Cool. Questions?
Okay, one question.
You just ran out of time. Sir?
You might have explained in the beginning, but is it possible to incorporate something like a drill press? Did you look into that?
Yes, we've done a lot of research on different drill presses. In fact, I can spend $120 and get a very nice pneumatic drill press. The idea behind this one, we didn't want to just go buy a drill press and be like, here's a drill press. Although
okay.
That is obviously the best solution. What we want to do, the whole point of our project was to incorporate what they already had, and they have a couple of wireless drills. So using that as a basis, because the cost was find a way for them to use their drills better, more efficiently. This is what we're trying to come up with, and also find a way to build this in which if something happens to it, it can be replaced relatively easy.
And it kind of kept like the drilling process the same for them, so like they could get the learning experience and the practice instead of just a...
Okay.
Thanks so much.